evening. Thank you. Thank you for the introduction. Thank you for inviting me to this annual dinner, the 88th gathering of this group. It is indeed an honor to be here and to experience firsthand the strength and determination of the Orthodox community. As you have heard, I have represented Sholom Agudah, Rubashkin in the case of the United States of America versus Sholom Agudah, Rubashkin. It has been my privilege to be his advocate in the struggle he has endured. A struggle he has been able to confront because of the immense support of this group and others in the Orthodox community. Please allow me to describe Sholom Agudah. He is, of course, married with 10 children. As you have heard, one child has special needs, a beautiful white lab. He has lived in Postal Iowa for the last 15 years. He's been involved in the community, extending beyond the business his father started, agri-processors, to the local religious and educational institutions. He has either founded or has been instrumental in the development of these institutions. Hundreds, thousands of letters and pledges of support for this man have come to the government and the court. He has a history of leadership and charity that's immense. Support for Sholom Agudah Rubashkin is unprecedented. These words I've just read to you are not my words as an advocate. These are the words spoken by the chief judge of the Northern District of Iowa, which released him on bail. These are true words. This is who this man is. I have come to know Sholom Agudah. I've come to know his family. As you've heard, I've spent more than a year in this community working with his family and other Orthodox members of the community. Literally hundreds of hours with him in all types of circumstances. I've come to know his wife and his family. I've been to the family's home in Brooklyn. I've eaten at his mother's soup kitchen in Borough Park. I've spent many hours with the committee of rabbis, Rabbi Hecht, Rabbi Brennan, and others who have supported him. I have read each and every letter and an email supporting his fair treatment. I have indeed come to know this man. He's a good man. He's a good person. He's forthright. He's well-intentioned. He's hard-working. He's dedicated. He's kind. He's sincere. He's good to his word. He's a problem solver. He's honorable. He's honest. And he's religious. Extremely observant. Again, these are not the words of an advocate speaking to you. These are not the words of Sholom Agudah's attorney. These are the words of witnesses spoken under oath, called by the government in the case against Sholom Agudah. He now awaits sentence. Having been convicted of 86 counts, multiple counts of the same conduct, the government sliced many ways to shock and awe the jury. At the core of what he stands convicted of is borrowing more money than his father's company was entitled to borrow, yet paying it back with interest. That is the core of what he stands convicted of. The government seeks a life sentence. Borrowing more money than his father's company was entitled to borrow, which was being paid back with interest. How did we get to this point? How did we get to where we are now? Let me share with you some of the true facts. Indeed, the real facts of this case. Many of you are acquainted with it by the fine reporting of many organizations, my friend Penny, and other groups.